finally closes. Yeah. What does this actually mean for IBM?
It really gives them a product to sell across the cloud ecosystem. So hybrid cloud is one of the biggest things in technology. Bulk of the IT spending is done by legacy companies like, you know, like JP Morgan, Pepsi, and so forth. And they are the ones who are going to partially move some of their stuff to public cloud and keep some of it internally. And Red Hat gives them the software capability to sell a whole number of services from consulting to implementation to the software piece of it. You know, this is something that I think IBM should have done a long while ago.
How quickly can IBM realize the benefits of this?
I think it'll take about 12 months or so. Unless we get into a macro slowdown, they should help their top line growth sometime in the second half of next year, in our view. And going into 2021, that's going to be good for them in terms of getting the top line growth up.
So it expands its offering. It really takes a huge chunk in cloud.
Yeah.
What about competition? Where does it stack up in terms of offerings with Microsoft, Amazon, et cetera? Cisco now looking at buying that communications
company. It's a very good
company.
Question. IBM was competing a lot with a lot of these vendors before. But with Red Hat, they're kind of neutral and will help people move wherever they want to move. As long as they keep that independence alive for Red Hat, they'll actually help customers move some workloads to Amazon, some to Microsoft, some to Google. Mm-hmm. And in that case, they will generate more money by selling software and services for clients to help that. So it's not going to be just IBM Cloud. It's going to be moving services across any cloud, whatever the customer wants.
So basically, as long as someone is buying something in the cloud or like buying services in the cloud, Red Hat's there.
Yes, and that's really key for them to make sure of that independence, that the Red Hat sales team should not go in and say, hey, we will help you move some stuff to the cloud, but you have to use IBM Cloud for it.
Based on your research in IBM, can they do that? Like, is it their culture to let a company operate so differently?
It's never been done before with this independence, but almost everything that we have heard on at least the press releases, the comments from the CEO, points us that this is the direction they're taking. Because in our view, if they don't take this direction, it's going to be very hard for them to be a good player in cloud long term.